For me, no other cut-rate game, Daft Broad, could be a replacement for L.A. Noire. Hello everyone, welcome back. I'm Chipper today, however, we have some sad news because we are going to be investigating the murder once again. Will this be the one where our dear detectives finally start piecing things together and admit that there is a serial killer? Let's watch and find out. Well, you watch, I'll play.
Into it. Yes, I'm aware that it's an election year. Keep a hold of your hat, counselor. Now is not the time to lose your nerve. It would appear that someone has hawked a rose gold wedding ring, a matching engagement ring. Sound familiar?
Deirdre Muller.
Press the pawnbroker and see what you can find out. The address is 348 South Main Street. The Muller case goes before the grand jury next week, and the DA does not want any egg on his face. Then get out to the railroad depot on Santa Fe Avenue. We have another poor unfortunate found this morning beside a railroad line. 40-year-old white woman.
Right, Skipper.
And if you guys will notice, that was the very first time that we've got a...
another body and Deirdre Muller's ring. The Emperor may soon have to come to terms with the fact that he's wearing no clothes.
What exactly did you get that book of riddles shoved up your ass, Phelps? Is that what your old man paid college tuition for?
Yes, actually.
That bum took a swipe at me.
Wow, this door's boarded up. That's bizarre. I never noticed that before. If you'll notice, that was the first...
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving.
That was the first time we've ever seen the murderer's face. It was kind of obscured, however. We got this pretty good look of it. I don't recognize the face right now, and you probably won't either unless you just really, really good with faces. But anyway, here are a few of the people that we've locked up. That gentleman there, we got locked up because he evaded the police. Don't run from the law, sir. And there should be... I can never find them. But, county, like the lockup where all of the murder suspects are at is supposed to be in this building somewhere. But as I said, I can never ever find them. I think they would have been back there at some point. Some other case, there may have all been back in those cells. But, too late. Yeah, bust in there and find that evidence. That's right. Anyway, since I've been doing a little bit of trivia every time, which I've looked up on some websites.
You're a reckless, bad person.
You've got to admit, this is looking odd.
Anyone could pawn a ring.
But if you take it along with all of the other indicators...
Cole, Hugo Muller was identified by the school's groundkeeper. He's our guy.
Witnesses have fingered the wrong guy before.
He ran, for God's sakes.
And he always maintained he was set up.
If you guys will notice, they acted like I pinned the Mueller case on Hugo Muller, but we did not. Remember, we got Eli Rooney for that. So there's a little bit of an error in scripting there. We did not charge Hugo Muller with that murder. Okay, so a little bit of trivia. The murderer that we're going to be investigating this cat time is actually based on the real-world murder of Evelyn Winters. Obviously, in the real world, she was not part of the Black Dahlia cases, but we're working in the game here. Okay, I stuck on the terrain there. That's great.
How can I help you, boys?
Give me everything you have behind the counter. No, I'm just joking.
Detectives Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. You have a rose gold wedding and engagement ring?
David Bremner.
Am I gonna get something for this pledge? Gave that bum money, now you guys are gonna leave me short.
How much did you give him?
$50.
Try another number.
20?
Try 10. Feel lucky you're getting it.
I have the rings right here.
Part of a murder investigation, sure, there's more important things than the money. I know. Maybe you don't think so, but it's true.
What's this mark here?
Maker's mark. Usually traceable. That one came from Hartfield's Jewelry down on Broadway.
Thanks for the tip.
Well, that's interesting. That's good to know. Maybe we can investigate that later. I forget if we actually do or not.
Does this mark mean anything?
Hallmark. Gives you an idea of the quality.
How do you not know that? You are married, Cole. Didn't you buy a wedding band?
What have you got on the guy who brought these in?
Goes by the name of Percy B. Shelley. Gave an address. 15 Poland Street, London, Tulare County.
Can you give us a description of the man who pawned these rings?
Not sure. Medium height, medium build. Dark hair, I think. Sorry. He just had one of those forgettable faces.
We'll be in touch, Mr. Bremner.
Yep, too bad there was no surveillance footage. A little bit too early in the century for that. Now, there is something of note about that address you gave, which I believe Cole Phelps will be telling us about here in a moment. I thought he was supposed to. That's bizarre. Oh well. Maybe as we drive through. Well, I keep being quiet, so he'll go ahead and spit out.
We have there a we problem. Go. We could have the local troopers check out the Tulare County address.
The address is bogus. Purpose having fun with us. The guy who's been sending the Dahlia letters is also the guy who pawned these rings.
How do you figure that?
Percy Bysshe Shelley wrote the poem that came with the Dahlia letter. The Dahlia letters are genuine. The man who killed Elizabeth Short may have also killed Deirdre Mullen.
And how do we prove that, Phil? Skipper ain't gonna like this one bit.
We're gonna have to rely on this guy tripping up on his own vanity.
Yep, so the information he gave was an obvious reference to Shelley, which he made a reference to in that letter he sent from, was it Prometheus Unchained, I believe? Or was it Unbound? I can never remember.
You boys ready? Follow me.
That's not the car I was driving. I was driving a police car.
We should keep this development with the rings under our hat until we speak with the captain.
We're all on the same team, Rusty.
Chain of command, Phelps. The skipper will decide who needs to know. Got it?
I get it, Rusty.
Yeah, we don't want to go letting everyone know that we completely screwed up. Oh, good.
Hard, isn't it?
Yeah. I look after all the rail depots.
What have you got?
The Negro, Nelson Gaines, called it in. I came down here to make sure him and the other guy, Jameson, stuck around.
Jameson found the body?
Something like that. Guy makes me sick.
We'll talk to the coroner. Keep an eye on both of them.
So we'll talk to this nice gentleman here who's being cooperative with the police. He's a good guy.
Detective Phelps and Galloway, homicide. Can you tell me exactly what happened?
We were shunting cars over to the main line when I saw this man here lying on top of this woman. The woman wasn't moving and seemed to be in a bad way.
What time was this?
About 7:30 this morning, sir.
Thanks for your help. Have you given Patrolman Hart your details?
I have, sir.
Thank you. You can go now.
Yep, so we have some more disgusting behavior from somebody here, but he's not our perp. He just happens to be a sick person.
What have we got here?
White female, approximately 40 years of age, lipstick smudges on the face, but no writing, at least nothing legible. A blunt force trauma to the temple, nose, and eye regions. Ligature marks point to the probable cause of death being strangulation. Any idea of the time of death?
From her temperature, after midnight would be my guess.
Yep. So I'm going to try and keep the camera pan over. I was having a good run. I had that one video where I didn't have to edit any nudity out. In this video, no such luck for myself, unfortunately.
Smell?
Very good. There is the usual evacuation smell, but it appears she's been living rough for quite some time.
Very strong smell of alcohol.
Well, the autopsy will tell, but I would assume that she was inebriated.
That tends to stick with the usual MO of grabbing drunk women as they stumble around.
Another missing ring.
Certainly seems I've been swabbing a lot of bare fingers recently.
Can you be more exact about the time of death?
No later than 2 a.m. The state the body was in, a 1 or 2 hour window is the best I can do.
Yep, so she was long, long dead before that other guy showed up. I'm not sure if that still counts, if you can still... I'm not sure about the laws regarding violating the dead. I have not actually made that a thing that I put too much time into consideration of.
This is a chit for personal items, not booze. It's not even worth investigating.
Yep, for Levine's Liquor Store. Right? I said that right? No, that's not the one I wanted. I want the bar. There we go. I believe this will be for the same place.
Maybe someone at Mensch's will remember her.
Oh, wow, no. Completely different bar. I forgot. Well, then. Lots of evidence for bars. Okay.
Someone was trying to get her to come home.
Huh. So somebody obviously cared about her, but whoever left her handbag here decided to keep the bottom half of that letter.
We could go over to the lot and see what they know about her.
That's gonna be difficult, Cole. The Keystone Studio lot closed back in 41.
Well then. That explains her vagrancy. She lost her job and just couldn't find another place of employment. This guy seems to...
What are you thinking, Ray?
The city keeps tossing us dead bodies. We're just running to catch up.
You seem really interested in this.
Optimistic, Cole.
Yeah. Like, I was staring it down pretty hard, so I was hoping there was something to do. But anyway, let's talk to this person.
Detective Phelps, LAPD Homicide.
John Ferdinand Jameson.
We need you to answer some questions, John.
If you don't mind, I prefer Ferdinand.
Don't push your luck, knucklehead.
What were you doing to the body, Ferdinand?
Are you sure you won't be upset?
Try me, Ferdinand.
I was kissing her. It's not against the law.
Shut up.
There's no law against it.
Take your beating like a man.
Turn out your pockets, Ferdinand. Classic carmine.
Yeah, that's the lipstick that's been used for other bodies. What was he doing with it?
Is this yours, Ferdinand?
No. I found it near her purse. I thought she could use some lipstick.
Rusty, stop! Don't hit him.
Please, Rusty, stop hitting him. Oh my god. I don't know how he hasn't had more misconduct charges against him, but you know.
You went through her purse?
It wasn't like she needed it. I took a look.
He seems very determined and stalwart in that particular thing he said, so let's go with truth on this.
Did you take any money?
Wasn't any to take. I found her lipstick and her matchbook over on the mat. Not much else.
Wait, so everything was on the mat before we got here? I thought that was maybe something that the other officers had done. But apparently those items were left there for display.
You found the body?
Yes, I did. I work here. I was coming off shift and headed home.
And he's hiding something. I wonder what that could be.
Why didn't you report the body, Jameson? Do you know how this is going to look to a jury?
A jury? What gives? I could tell that she was dead. I came through here about midnight last night. She wasn't here then.
Let me belt him again.
You're under arrest, Jameson. We'll see how this plays out. Until then, you can think a little on how you'd like to be treated if you were found dead.
I'm telling you, it's not illegal. Me and some friends of mine...
Clyde, can you get this sack of shit into a cell? I'll deal with him later.
Sure, Rusty.
Leave the car in front of the hydrant and I'll give you a ticket.
Thanks. Anyway, yeah. Rusty is not very fond of sexual perversion. And I don't blame him.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need an address on Levine's Liquor. Closest store to the Santa Fe Avenue rail yard, if possible.
Just a moment, Detective. Closest store would be the one at 939 South Hope Street.
Thank you.
I just have to wonder sometimes, you know, I'm sure, I know they sped everything up just to make it more accessible for a time frame standpoint, but can you just imagine all those phone operator women who had to have all these, like, documents and just vast amounts of data and stuff in, like, sheafs of paper piled up at their desk? So that they could look up all this crap for police officers. I can't imagine what a stack of paperwork there would have to be for one.
You read that those goddamn Chinese want to sell the relief food that we're sending them?
Yeah. Yeah, I read about that.
Those people are starving. They can't do that.
They want to sell the food to fund the civil war against the communists.
Really? I guess that's okay, then.
Armies can't fight without food. Spend all your money on weapons, but you still have to have the will to fight. Fortunately, the Reds will win in China.
Watch your mouth. You know what you're saying?
The people of this country overthrew a king. You think the Chinese will balk at an emperor if they are starving?
And as it turns out, our dear Mr. Cole Phelps was correct. Of course, it's unfavorable to even be kind to those dirty Reds this time period, but that's just how it went, unfortunately. Oh, okay, now. Gotta check your mirrors, sir. You can't just drive into me like that. Jeez, for this place being the closest to the railway station, it was a long drive away. Holy shit. Anyway, we are here, finally. Oh. Man, they sell all the addictions. I wonder if they sell some of that morphine in here.
What can I do for you?
LAPD, Phelps and Galloway. We're making inquiries into the murder of Evelyn Summers.
Evelyn? She's dead?
You knew Evelyn Summers, Mr.
Robbins? Yes, I knew Evelyn. I was a good friend of her ex-husband. She kept some of her stuff here.
Can you show us, please?
Sure. Come this way.
So, yeah, apparently she was shacking up in this liquor store.
You got some fine stock here, Mr. Robbins. Now you let us take some for the road, this case might get solved a lot quicker.
Oh my god. Come on, Rusty.
He's joking, Mr. Robbins.
She kept a bed here, but I probably shouldn't have let her. An alcoholic in a liquor store, that was never going to work out, was it?
We'll take a look around.
Yeah, probably wouldn't. It wasn't going to, but what are you going to do?
I'm guessing Evelyn hadn't held down a job for quite some time before she was killed.
Ah, she has an award.
When exactly did Evelyn work in the pictures?
A few years ago. She worked in legal copyrights for music.
Copyrights. Copyrights. Anyway, let's take a look at this.
She wasn't always such a loner.
Yep, so as you said, she was married at one point, and I guess those were her friends.
Evelyn was reading Aristotle?
Evelyn wasn't stupid. The only stupid thing about her was her need to drink.
That's quite the heavy read.
And she was borrowing books from Grosvenor McCaffrey.
There we are. So we have another name. Broken mirror? I assume that she, maybe she didn't like looking at herself. Self-loathing from, addicts. It's not uncommon. Oh, okay, what am I missing then? Is it the bowling pin? Did I really need to look at that? I did. Shows what I know.
Rawlings Bowling Alley. Maybe Evelyn did something other than drink in her spare time.
Rawlings. I know that place. Corner of 9th and Grand. A lot of cops bowl there on Tuesday nights.
So apparently Rusty is part of the police officers bowling league. Wouldn't really peg him as that kind of guy, but yeah, you know. I guess any activity where you're allowed to drink without being judged is something he'll do.
We're trying to account for Evelyn's movements yesterday.
She came by in the morning.
A social visit to pick up some of her things?
She had a couple of bucks and bought a quart of rye.
Yeah, I believe you.
Any idea where the money came from?
She didn't mention it. But she did say the booze was a present for a boy. She said they had been fighting and she had to make it up to him.
Uh-huh, so she apparently had herself a beau.
Were you and Evelyn close, Mr. Robbins?
Not many people will be sad she's gone. I'll be one of the few.
We got the impression that Evelyn had been sleeping rough of late.
It became difficult for me to have her staying here. Her mother was trying to get her back on the straight and narrow. She's old now. And to be honest, you have to have a good reason to want to get back on.
That is true. You can't just, a lot of people have trouble with finding a reason to no longer drink.
Do you know a friend of Evelyn's by the name of McCaffrey?
Not personally.
I think there's a little bit more he wants to tell us.
We're struggling for leads, Robbins. Did she know McCaffrey?
She idolized him. From what I gather, the feeling was far from mutual. He seems to peddle a revolutionary stance, fixing the ills of society. You could see how it would appeal to down-and-outs like Evelyn.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Robbins.
No problem. Hey, I'd like to make arrangements for the funeral. You think I could get in touch with Evelyn's mother?
Put in a call to the watch commander at Central Station, Mr. Robbins. He'll be trying to reach the next of kin.
Thanks. Get the guy, huh? Evelyn never hurt anybody.
All right, so the guy that he was talking about that she loaned the books from, he apparently is going to be a communist, I would assume. So him and Rusty won't get along famously, I am sure. Anyway, we had another bar to go look at, so let's go look at that bar.
Phelps, Galloway, Homicide. We need to ask you some questions concerning Evelyn Summers.
I'm Walter Mensch. Evelyn Summers? What is it now?
You knew Evelyn?
As well as I wanted to know, Evelyn. She's a pain in the ass, always coming in here, cadging drinks, never had any money. She was in just a couple of nights ago.
Did she ever tell you where she was staying?
I don't know. I think she was living rough. She had that kind of stunk about her.
Who did she drink with?
A bunch of these guys. Ask around.
You know, whoever.
You a friend of Evelyn Summers?
Who's asking?
Very cute. You know who's asking.
I know my rights.
You don't have any. Answer the question.
Evelyn mooches for drinks. I don't have any time for that.
Was that so hard?
Keep writing me, copper.
Oh, well, if we want to. I can see you try to retaliate.
What's your name?
Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Mind if I ask you some questions, Mr. McCaffrey?
I'm just a starving writer, detective. What do you want to ask about?
Evelyn Summers, and why she was found beaten and strangled in the rail depot on Santa Fe.
Okay. I see your point.
How well did you know her?
I can't say that I knew her. It was more like I was aware of her.
All right. I already don't like this guy. And on top of that, based on the cutscene we saw at the beginning and the description that the pawnbroker gave us, this guy could very easily be the guy that we're looking for.
Do you have a criminal record, Mr. McCaffrey?
Nothing serious. I've had a few skirmishes.
Uh-huh. Is that right? I think I'll probably doubt that.
You want to save me some time, or do you want me to look up your file?
Industrial disputes, strikes, workers' rights, that kind of thing.
A regular fifth columnist. Nice to meet you, comrade.
Oh, ever the wonderful interrogator there, Rusty.
You say you barely knew Evelyn?
Yes, that is correct.
We'll go ahead and call that a lie.
You're lying, McCaffrey. You looked down your nose at Evelyn, but you knew her, and you have some idea of what happened.
I hope you're holding aces. I'm telling you again, I barely knew the woman.
And yes, she has one of your books.
Why would you lend her your book on metaphysics if you only knew her in passing? It was more than that. A Renaissance man like yourself, lending his books to his acolytes.
She hounded me about that goddamn book, and then she lifts it from my apartment and lies to my face that she didn't take it, as if she could even comprehend any of it. I saw her go into a hotel with Tiernan last night. They had booze in a paper bag. He's your man.
Thank you for the information, Mr. McCaffrey.
You're still going to be a person of interest, so don't go anywhere. They keep giving me the stupid car. I don't want that ugly car. That car is ugly. Stop giving it to me. I want the cop car. Look at how sleek and shiny this thing is.
Delicious. Car 11K. Car 11K.
What the hell? What was that? Okay, so Rusty apparently somehow glitched the game out and canceled out the bulletin, the thing we're supposed to have to tell us to come back to Central. I enjoy driving on the wrong side of the road. It's very liberating.
Need a drink. I got the jitters again.
The captain is downstairs with Ray Pinker and Carruthers.
Oh, no, yeah, that's right. That's what it is. Another letter has come in. That's what it was.
Isn't he the cop they've been talking about on the radio?
Yeah, everyone's been talking about me, man. I'm famous.
Hey, don't mind me.
What's this about, Captain?
Ray and Mal have some concerns over the Henry and Muller cases, which I don't want aired outside of this room.
The evidence is solid, Captain.
I agree, Rusty. It's just that corpses keep piling up.
Copycats.
I've been banging the same drum. But the notes and the lipstick messages.
Evelyn Summers, Cartel Classic Carmine. Each woman, same brand, same color.
Teresa Terrelson didn't have a lipstick message.
Technically, you're right, Rusty. She didn't have any lipstick. But she did have a message. We found it beneath her dress, scraped with a sharp stick.
What did it say?
You sure you want to know,
Ray?
As far as we can be sure, it said, cunt BD.
That's one way of looking at it.
Looking at what?
Cunt is all about access, Phelps. You're married, so yours is mortgaged. Some of us like to pay by installments. This guy doesn't like to pay at all.
Why are you so angry, Mal?
Because I just had to fire one of my assistants. He was a friend of Jameson's. God knows what he might have been up to.
Captain, we have good leads in the Summers case, but it's up to you to decide how we proceed.
Keep this under your hat for now. And to follow up on Evelyn Summers, I want daily reports.
Yeah, but if you remember, Jameson was the,
We got our orders. Oh. Back to the Summers case. Get an address for McCaffrey. He'll have blown the bar. I'll meet you outside.
Okay. So if you remember, Jameson was the guy who was violating the body that we found at the rail yard. So if one of his guys working at the morgue was friends with Jameson, and Jameson said him and his friends have been doing stuff, that does not bode well.
Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address for a Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Grosvenor McCaffrey. Apartment 6, 126 Yale Street, between Ord and Alpine.
Thanks, ma'am.
So, we have Tiernan as a suspect as well. However, I guess we don't have any interest in looking up who he is yet.
Let me pose a question.
Depends. What you got to do with?
Morals. Would it bother you to put the wrong person away?
Depends.
On what?
On whether anyone except the poor son of a bitch in the slammer ever found out.
Wow, that's an interesting question to a moral dilemma there, Rusty. I'm not quite sure that's the outlook that cops are supposed to have regarding the validity of the charges they've filed against people. But I'm sure it's not as uncommon as it should be.
Hello, Rusty. Two on your usual lane?
I'm Detective Phelps. Homicide.
You must be new. What's your shoe size?
We're conducting an investigation, ma'am. Do you know the name Evelyn Summers?
Sounds like I should. Oh, maybe it could be Jimmy's friend.
Jimmy?
James Tiernan. He's a pin setter. One day he introduced me to a lady after work. Stuck in my mind because she was much older, too old for him.
Where can we find Jimmy, Florence?
He'll be hopping around the lanes toward the back.
Thanks, ma'am. Let's go get him.
And there he goes. Not quite sure why he's running, but I'm okay.
Tiernan! LAPD!
Oh, come on now.
There!
Why do you always have to run, Jimmy boy?
What are you waiting for? Get after him!
We might go faster if we weren't carrying the extra weight.
Yeah, fatty.
These are flashy cars to be parked outside a bowling alley.
The lanes attract a fast-living individual with money to burn.
Or a middle-aged individual with the need to feel virile.
Keep it steady and I'll try to bust his tires! Another runner. Well, at least we've got a suspect.
Why do they always run? I'm sure we've got the wrong person in more than one of these homicides, but they always seem to land it.
You know, your theories are not airtight by any means.
Don't go to sleep on me. Get me back in close.
If this isn't the killer, we can at least get him for reckless endangerment.
That's unless he runs into a wall and saves us all the trouble.
Or unless he does that.
Put your hands where I can see them.
Oh, wow. I've never seen that happen before. That's an interesting little glitch. Amazing. It's too bad we didn't get to see him drive off. That would have been hilarious. We have another suspect, and just judging by the few glimpses of his face that we got to have, he could very easily have been the murderer as well, just based on the opening cutscene. Please forgive me, everyone. I must find a police car, so there's no radio. Just give me a moment. I'll cut. What am I saying? Give me a moment. I'm gonna cut it so you don't see all this. Alright, let's play our little game of find out what apartment he's in. Okay, so I was trying to anyway. Six.
McCaffrey is in apartment 6.
I just said that goal. Stop repeating me, sir. Anyway, I suppose 6 will be on floor 2? Yeah. Awesome. Yeah, try.
Doesn't look like anybody's home.
Try and knock like you're a police officer as much as you can.
Terrible shame. Means there's nobody to let us in. You want to do the honors, Phelps?
Oh, we're just going to break in. Well, no problem. This guy is looking real good to be our suspect, though. He's an incredibly learned person. He apparently likes obscure books. He's got a statue of some Tibetan thing, I think, on his desk.
Good to me.
See, the problem right now I'm going to have is I'm going to offend somebody because I'm not sure what that statue is. And maybe I should. Ah, and he has the other half of that note that we found.
Torn from the letter we found beside the body. At the very least, I'd say it ties McCaffrey to the scene.
Yep, so unfortunately her life was cut short before she had the chance to
hasn't given me anything to go on.
Take her mother up on that offer. Oh my.
He said he was at home. He said he didn't know her. And we have the book.
Let's see Carruthers argue his way out of this one.
Is that you, Grosvenor? Who are you guys? What are you doing in here?
We're from the LAPD, ma'am. Do you know where we might find McCaffrey?
I'm his neighbor. Is he in trouble?
Look, lady, we need to find him, and in a hurry. Are you going to give me trouble?
He has a pigeon coop up on the roof. He spends his mornings up there when he's been drinking.
How do we get up there?
Down the hall and up the stairs.
Drunk and in command of a carrier pigeon. Surely we can ride him up for that. A citation, at least.
Probably not, Rusty. And yeah, he's got his shirt just completely splattered with blood that we did not get to look at. But we got all the clues still, so that's all that matters, right? What the hell was that? Oh, she's smoking. Okay. I was like, that was a weird hand gesture. What the hell?
That's the guy. I heard he's an honest cop. Now that's an oxymoron for you.
Your head doesn't fit your body. Our believe, roof access. Whoa. Yeah, oh, wait, here we are. Yeah, roof access. There we go. It's like it's around here somewhere. Oh, he's gonna run, isn't he?
Grosvenor McCaffrey!
Running on a hangover, McCaffrey? Sit down and we'll talk. I'll go get our wheels.
Wow, I just held up that whole time, and the game took care of it all for me. Thank you, game. I hate confusing camera angles ruining my control scheme. So thoughtful. He's not going to try and box me, is he? That would be unfortunate for him. I have a feeling he's not very good in a fight. Why can't I sprint?
You a runner, McCaffrey? Stay and fight the good fight.
Yeah, comrade. Come back here, you pinko commie bastard. Why can't I catch this guy? Holy crap.
There he is. See him?
Like if the game's not letting me sprint. Oh, here we go. There we are.
McCaffrey, you're under arrest on suspicion of murdering Evelyn Summers.
The punches may be unnecessary there, Cole. This guy seems like he might know his rights.
We need to get downtown and wrap this thing up. It's gotta be McCaffrey. Unless Tyrannan set him up. You don't think that asshole Jameson did anything, do you? Yeah, whoever did it, was that Dahlia.
How do you know that McCaffrey didn't do the Dahlia?
We have a list of over 200 suspects. His name was never on it.
If you think the list is exhaustive, Rusty, who am I to argue?
Listen, let's just work the case at hand, shall we? Then we can sit down and put all the puzzle pieces together at a later date.
I'll hold you to that.
Now I'm driving on the train tracks. That's not advice for you fine folks. Don't do that at home, kids. Again, we are set up with two suspects.
You sure you can make it stick with one of these suspects, gentlemen?
It's either McCaffrey or Tiernan, sir. I think Jameson is an aberration.
All right. I'll deal with that degraded lunatic myself. He's got some fearful retribution coming. Tiernan isn't one, McCaffrey isn't two. I want the confession from one of them. Don't fail me, young Phelps.
Yeah, we can do that, Captain. Let's go ahead and get talk to Tiernan first.
And he still confessed.
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving up.
Why
to
did you run?
I want to put him down in one round.
I was the last one to see Evelyn that night. I knew you would think it was me.
Okay, so another thing to keep in mind. I mentioned that this case was based on the real life murder of Evelyn Winters. Well. This guy's name is actually based off of the person who was charged with her murder. I can't remember what his name was now, but it was really close. So, let's see if we can go about convicting this guy of the crime as well.
Can you describe your relationship with Evelyn?
I barely knew Evelyn.
Yeah, that's a lie.
Keep lying to me and I'll have you charged and in front of a grand jury before your feet touch the ground.
How can you possibly prove Evelyn and I were more than friends?
Oh, incredibly easily, actually. In fact, you kind of knew that we would know that already. Yeah, let's go with this.
McCaffrey gave you up, Tiernan. He says he saw you go into your hotel with Evelyn.
I met Evelyn at the public library. We would read for a while and then go for a drink. Last night, we went back to my hotel room and had some more to drink. I must have passed out. I woke up and she was gone.
What time was this?
Around midnight, maybe later.
And there's no one who can confirm this.
No, there isn't. I knew you wouldn't believe me.
Yeah, definitely not looking good for you, sir.
Aristotle's Metaphysics, the book that belonged to McCaffrey.
McCaffrey saw her looking at it once and laughed in her face.
And you're saying Evelyn stole it?
She wanted something of his.
Oh, and he's still not being forthcoming with us. Look at that face. Is that face that we lied to us? Of course it is.
We either hang this on you or McCaffrey. You better give us something.
Well, McCaffrey's been in trouble with the law before. I mean, he always makes out it was some kind of labor dispute. But, you know, I'm not so sure.
You sound desperate there, Mr. Tiernan.
You and Evelyn were drinking together last night, and she had no other place to stay.
I don't know what happened last night. I don't remember.
Hey, it's quite possible he doesn't remember. However, we're supposed to say that he's lying here.
You're lying, Tiernan. You'd been fighting with her. You fought, and...
I'm not lying! She got up and left! That was it!
See, you're not supposed... I wouldn't think to know that that's the direction that we were going to go with that. However, here's our bit of evidence. She bought the liquor for a boy to make up for arguing.
She left, but she came back. She bought you a quart of whiskey to make it up to you. She told the liquor store owner, "You're in deep trouble, buddy."
She said she loved me. She wanted to care for me. But she would never stop talking about McCaffrey. McCaffrey was a writer. McCaffrey was a hero. McCaffrey cared for the little guy.
Did you kill her, Tiernan?
I might as well have. I kicked her out. She had nowhere to go.
Yep, you're a horrible person.
Do you own a car, Tiernan?
No, I don't.
Have access to a lug wrench?
We use a lot of them to clear jams in the pin setting machines.
Oh, I got the shifty eye going.
Coroner's report says that Evelyn was killed with a wrench. I think you did it and then planted the evidence at McCaffrey's apartment for us to find.
We went to his apartment. McCaffrey was up on the roof. Evelyn stole the book. McCaffrey went crazy when he found out. He said he would put her out of her misery. He can be very cruel.
Okay, well, let's leave now.
Evelyn was missing a ring from her right hand.
That's strange. She always wore it. A big black circular disc with a white E in the middle. It was made from an old typewriter key, a present from the prop department at her old movie studio.
We're going to talk to McCaffrey. You need to think about what you've told us, Tiernan. You're not in the clear.
Not in the clear by far.
I want to make Homicide. I mean, you know you've made it if you got
But
that.
We do have to talk to the other suspect at the very least. It's only right.
You ready to answer some questions?
You think I have all the answers?
People who run from the police usually have something to hide.
Touché, detective. Let's see where this takes us.
Yeah, you're not like a sociopath at all. Anyway, let's get on with this.
Evelyn died sometime around midnight. Remind me, where were you?
I was at home, writing. I'm working on a manuscript.
Let's go with no.
You're lying, McCaffrey. You were out at the rail yard.
And what do you have that proves I was there?
Only everything.
How about half of Augusta Summers' last correspondence with her daughter?
What are you talking about?
After you were done beating Evelyn, you searched her and found her mother's letter. That old lady's anguish amused you.
I know nothing about a letter or Evelyn's goddamn mother.
So what was it doing on your writing desk?
I don't know, but... if I didn't put it there, somebody else did. Try exercising your powers of deduction on that.
Very informative, thank you.
We found the lug wrench that Evelyn was battered with in your apartment, and the note from her mother, and your blood-stained clothing. We have you cold, McCaffrey.
You think if I could be bothered to murder Evelyn Summers, I would be stupid enough to leave the evidence in my apartment?
That's a good point, but you're still... kind of lying a little bit here.
I don't believe you, Grosvenor. The evidence says that you killed her.
You can prove that I wanted to kill Evelyn?
Well, yeah, she kind of stole that book from you.
Tiernan is prepared to testify that you threatened Evelyn's life in his presence.
Self-preservation. That's understandable. Okay, I'll level with you. Tiernan killed Evelyn. He came to me for help. I listened to him, and he explained why he did it.
Tiernan went to you for help. You expect me to buy that?
That's how it went down. I told him he made a terrible mistake, but he would be throwing his life away if he went to the cops. I took his things and told him I would dispose of them.
But you didn't.
Speak to Tiernan. He'll give it up.
Back and forth we go. Interview one, interview the other, yeah.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need the jacket on a Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Just a moment, Detective. McCaffrey was formerly under surveillance by the Red Squad. Convictions for petty theft. Dishonorable discharge from the Army during training at Syracuse. Assault on a local woman. Says he almost beat the woman to death.
Thanks.
Well, that's an interesting little criminal charge there. Remarkably close to what happened here. Oh, and upon looking it up, the guy who was actually charged with the murder of Evelyn Winters in real life, his name was actually James Tiernan. Who... so they named him directly after the guy who was charged with the murder.
You spoken to McCaffrey? I can go? It's all been cleared up?
Not quite. We have one more question we need to ask, James. Then I think we will be done.
Sure. Go ahead.
So Evelyn passed out, and you walked out. What happened next?
I woke up in the morning, very hungover. I thought Evelyn would come back.
I know you're lying, James. You went out looking for her. Tell me what really happened.
I don't know what you're talking about. How can you say I wasn't in that hotel room?
Because you're a really horrible liar.
You wound up at McCaffrey's. You were still incredibly drunk. You passed out on his floor. It's time to tell me what really happened.
McCaffrey woke me up the next morning. And he showed me the lug wrench and the letter and the box. And he said I came in with him last night. He said that I killed Evelyn. And that it was all over the radio. And that he would protect me. And I don't know, Detective, for the life of me, I can't remember a goddamn thing. I was angry with her. Really angry. I could have done it. Was it me?
I'm going to go with no.
Sounds wait like, here.
And he still confessed.
Sounds to me like McCaffrey was having a little bit of fun with you. So let's go talk to him and see what he has to say about that.
You were in the war?
Yes, I was. Seeing the things that I saw. It changes a man. I came back here determined to change things. All I wanted was a pen and an opportunity to speak out.
You told us before that you had only minor run-ins with the police. You didn't mention petty theft.
I've never been in trouble for violence. That's the salient point here, isn't it?
Why would you even say that? You know that we looked up your criminal record.
You're lying, McCaffrey. You have a history of violence towards women.
How do you turn a couple parking tickets and a petty theft misdemeanor into an assault charge?
Like, you do realize we looked up... Like, we keep track of these things in your criminal record. We don't just forget to write that down.
We know all about you and your dishonorable discharge, beating some poor woman near to death in Syracuse. You've never been in combat, McCaffrey.
Your whole life is a fraud.
She was a goddamn peasant whore! She tried to steal from my wallet! I could have fought for this country! I could have...
You beat her because she stole from you. Because she tried to outsmart you.
The ignorant audacity of the bitch! What is a man supposed to do? Sit there and take it? How is a man supposed to call himself a man?
And Evelyn Summers, a poor, drunken nobody, stole your book.
And she got what was coming to her!
Hope you enjoy prison. Oh my gosh, you got some anger issues, sir. Maybe you and Rusty can have some discussions about your shared misogyny.
Grosvenor McCaffrey, I'm charging you with the murder of Evelyn Summers. She was a sad lady who never hurt anyone except herself. I hope God finds a way to forgive you.
Congratulations, boys, you bagged the fine catch. Another red to boot. Grand. Now, I want you to put this business about a repeat offender out of your mind. This McCaffrey creature shows no remorse, and neither will the grand jury. You would have to walk a long mile to find a better candidate for an unmarked plot in a prison graveyard.
Cole looks really pleased with himself there. That's funny. Are we gonna get the war flashback here? Come on, game. I believe in you. Wow, that's a lot of vehicle damage. I can't. Oh no! Oh my god! I caused so much vehicle damage, I knocked myself down to a 4-star rating on this case. Oh my. Well, anyway, if you're looking at this to try and get a 5-star run, just don't hit as many cars as I did and you'll be okay. Wow!
We have lost most of Shaughnessy and Dunn's squad. The gunny is dead, first platoon is in worse shape. That medic is either crazy or the bravest man alive.
Can we rally with the first? Then try for the Nambus.
It's sheared to the left. To the right, it goes right through a pass with two Nambus and Infilade.
Mate,
we can lose everyone!
Descend, Lieutenant! Get back off this fucking bridge! They'll start walking the mortars back to their own positions! We only have
minutes! I'm in charge here, Sergeant!
Get your men off the bridge, Lieutenant!
What's your unit, Sergeant?
We don't have time for this, Lieutenant!
What's your unit, Sergeant?
My company, 22nd Marines, Lieutenant. And we just saved your ass by fording the river.
My orders are to reconnoiter the...
I think that point is now moot! You have 10 men left! My orders are to save what's left! Move out!
Mr. Cole was being a little bit stubborn there with, being a little stubborn there about, his thing. So in any case, everyone, that will be that for this one. Thank you for joining me. Next time, things are going to ramp up, hit a very intense high note as we get to the last of the murder cases, and everything's going to kind of come together. So, I hope you all will join me, and I will see you then.